This is not some opinion. This is a mathematical fact. Tens of trillions of dollars are being extracted from the United States of America.
Dylan Ratigan, mad as hell, and with a message for Washington, wake up! That impromptu rant on yesterday's show has a lot of people still buzzing 24 hours later. And Dylan himself is taking a few minutes out from writing his book now to join us on the hotline. Dylan Ratigan, welcome to the Dylan Ratigan Show.
It's a very meta experience. I'm more nervous to come on my own show as a phoner than I am to host it.
Well, Dylan, obviously this has really touched a nerve. Huge reaction on Twitter, all across the blogosphere. What did you mean by the extraction that people ought to be upset about? Say a little more about that to keep the information flowing for folks.
What I was trying to communicate was my sense that everybody, whether you're a conservative, whether you're a liberal, whether you're a Democrat, a Republican, or an independent, or a Martian worshiper, you are aware that the American tax code is bought, that those who fund our politicians get beneficial tax treatment, whether it's corn, whether it's the health insurance and corporate health insurance, or whether it is the oil companies, or whether it's loopholes for wealthy versus those who work. Regardless of what you think the tax code should be, everybody knows it's a bought code. Everybody knows that the trade agreement with China is extracting money from us. We get a report every month, half of our trade deficit every month is as a result of the fact that China taxes us 10 times what we tax them. They're at 25% for U.S. imports, we're at 2.5%, and they discount their... Everybody knows that. Everybody knows that the banking system is not incentivized, is not structured to take the trillions that we give it and lend or facilitate an investment market that's investing in America. And that is costing us tens of trillions of dollars. We're truly harvesting our own wealth for the benefit of a few interests in trade, banking, and the tax code that fund our politicians. And I think everybody knows that. And I think for me, I guess it just boiled over a little bit.
It clearly struck a nerve, even more so when you see the market turmoil like we've seen the last couple of days, when it seems like the jig may be up on the whole global economic system in ways that you've been talking about for some time now. Now that people seem to be energized and they're looking for, what can I do? What actions can I take? What would you tell people that they ought to be doing now that they can do to make a difference, to try and turn the ship of state around?
The stunning thing for me, and as you mentioned this at the top, is the overwhelming nature of the response, not just of people who share the emotion that I'm feeling, but also people who have amazing ideas as to what can be done. And so I was thinking about that and thinking about all the energy and the anger and the frustration and how both valuable and how dangerous that energy is, Matt. You know, it's an intense thing when people are this frustrated. And I think that the most valuable thing for everybody to do, and we wrote something about this today that I think is circulating on the Huffington Post and our own, and DylanRatigan.com and all this, that goes like this. If you understand how the tax code and the banking system and the trade systems are misaligned, are unfair, explain it to everybody that you know. Help them better understand this. This is anybody can understand this if those who understand it take the time to help those who don't understand it. That's the first thing. You have to learn. You have to educate yourself before you use this energy, because you don't want to use it wrong. The second thing is, if you don't know what's going on with taxes, trade, and banking, and how that can be used to either drive money into any nation, not just ours, every nation uses banking, trade, and tax policy to affect flow of capital by the trillion into their country, ask for help. Ask somebody. Say, I don't understand this tax, trade, and banking thing. And if we simply start on the process of beginning ourselves to learn more about how that affects the giant flows that we're dealing with right now, I think we'll be in a much better position as the months unfold, because as you just pointed out, Matt, this is not going away, to make better informed, more wise decisions as this goes. And so I think that that's the second biggest thing. And then the last thing, if you want to do something right now, you know, is there are three trade agreements that are NAFTA-style agreements. One with Panama promotes banking secrecy. One with South Korea that promotes paying slaves in North Korea that then refunds the North Korean government. And one with Colombia that does business with the country that leads the world in assassinating union organizers on a level that makes their per capita number look insane. If you want to do something about that right now, trade is the thing that's going to be the most active politically, and you can call Congress, you know, 202-224-3121. Give them your zip code and tell them what you think about the trade deals. But I would focus mostly on just learning about how our American tax, trade, and banking policy is affecting is basically causing money to leave our nation for the benefit of a few people in the short term. And I think we all know that. We just need to actually figure out a way to engage it.
Well, Dylan, I know you're working hard now for your book, Greedy Bastards, which will really further that cause of deepening public understanding of all these issues in a way that you've been so passionate and eloquent about, in a way that's really striking a nerve. Let us let you go back to work. Thanks for dropping by your own show, Dylan Ratigan.
Yeah, well, one thing before I go, Matt, is yes. A lot of people have been reaching out and trying to figure out how to communicate. If people want to get in touch with me, the best way to do it is we created an email inbox that's madashell@dylanratigan.com. And so because we're getting a lot of incoming, and honestly, the best if we can communicate on a single channel, I think it'll be a more constructive conversation for everybody. So madashell@dylanratigan.com if you want to engage on this conversation.
Be well, Dylan. I'm proud to keep your chair warm for a couple of days while you're hard at work on the book.
You're doing great, Matt, and I'm grateful for your partnership in carrying the torch.
We'll be talking to you soon then.
Okay, take care.
Up next,